Today we are going to learn about the triangle of auscultation. I'm going to use the web-based platform called 4D Anatomy, which is actual dissection images captured in a 3D format, which enables you to virtually dissect through the layers. Okay, the link for this platform is there in the description below. So what we are seeing here is the trapezius muscle. I made a video on trapezius muscle before. You can see that for a detailed description on the trapezius. This is the lower fibers of the trapezius that is ascending up from the lower aspect of the thorax towards the pectoral girdle. So this forms the lateral border of the trapezius. This muscle that you see here is the latissimus dorsi, a very powerful and a strong muscle that takes a wide origin from a lot of structures in the lower part of the thorax and the pelvis, and it converges towards the humerus. And this muscle, the upper border of this muscle is located here. And here you have the medial border of the scapula. The medial border of the scapula, the latissimus dorsi, which is formed by the thumbs, and the trapezius, which is ascending up, forms a triangular opening, okay, triangular window, and this is called the triangle of auscultation. The triangle of auscultation is located in the lower aspect of the thorax, a little bit laterally. So the triangle of auscultation is basically a window within the posterior lateral aspect of the thorax. And the importance of this triangle is that it is a window where if you place a stethoscope over the triangle of auscultation, you have minimal impedance between the stethoscope and the lung sounds. Why I said that is because here you have a thick muscle called trapezius, here you have a thick muscle called latissimus dorsi, and here you have the scapula with a lot of thick muscles, for example infraspinatus, the rhomboids, the teres major here, and on the deeper side you have subscapularis and the serratus anterior. So all these muscles will be they're intervening between the lung and the stethoscope, but this is a relative rarer space where you have minimal muscles. So here the muscles that you have will be the chest wall along with the iliocostalis muscle of the erector spinae. That will be the only muscles that has to go through, that the sounds of the lung sounds has to pass through to reach the stethoscope. So the triangle of auscultation is one of the best areas where you can auscultate the lung sounds. So the importance of this is that you can actually manipulate this triangle of auscultation in a person. You cannot change the position of trapezius, you cannot change the position of latissimus dorsi, but you can change the position of the scapula. You can cause a protraction of the scapula by bringing your hand forwards or bringing your hand towards. My left scapula will be protracted. This left scapula can be protracted by bringing the hand towards the opposite shoulder. So that will create the movement of the medial border more laterally, expanding the triangle of auscultation. So the ideal position of the patient where you can place a stethoscope on the posterior aspect of the thorax to hear the best lung sounds will be in a bent and crossed hand position, in which the triangle of auscultation will be widened on both aspects and you can best hear the lung sounds by placing the stethoscope. So here you have only minimal muscles, that the erector spinae muscles and a little bit of rhomboids over here, that may be the only muscles that you have to go through when you place the stethoscope over the region of the triangle of auscultation. Thank you.